Every digital painting application comes with a set of default shortcuts, and so does Krita. Those shortcuts are designed to fasten the most common operations. However, they can't answer the needs of every type of users. And more importantly, they can't answer all of our individual needs as artists, as we are all going to define our own workflow eventually. And we all have different favorite tools too. That's why every artist should at least know that it's possible, and even recommended, to change their keyboard shortcuts. In Krita, it is very easy to edit your shortcuts. Just go to the Settings menu and to Configure Shortcuts. All of Krita's tools and functions can be assigned a key combination here, apart from canvas-related manipulations, like pan, zoom, or resizing your brush, for example. Everything that happens directly on your document. The window lists all of Krita's available shortcuts. Type the name of a tool in the search bar to find it quickly. Then, to change its shortcut, you simply have to click on the entry, click on the rectangle button next to Custom, and then just enter your key combination directly on the keyboard. Then, at the bottom of the UI, just click the OK button to save your changes. In case your shortcut conflicts with an existing one, Krita will warn you, and it will allow you to either reassign the shortcut to the currently selected tool or to cancel the operation. That's all I'll show you for now, as the shortcut manager and default shortcuts are being improved in the next version of Krita. So we'll look more into it when Krita 3 is out. Maybe you're wondering, when should I change my shortcuts? I advise you to change your keybinding slowly over time, as you discover new tricks that you like. I follow a simple formula for my own shortcuts. I set the function I use the most to single keys I can comfortably reach with my left hand, as I'm right-handed. I change shortcuts one at a time so I can easily learn them. Also, if there are multiple functions that I use a bit less but are similar to ones that have an assigned shortcut, I bind them to the same key with a modifier. So I use a single letter for tools and priority. I use Ctrl plus a key for a function that transforms something in Krita. That's the case with the merge, the duplicate layer shortcuts, with the transform tool, for instance. And I will use the Alt key for a similar function, but with an alternate or opposite effect. To give you an example, by default in Krita, you have Ctrl J to duplicate a layer, and you have Ctrl-Alt-J to only duplicate your current selection to a new layer. And this wraps up our quick start guide. There are many, many features we haven't covered yet in Krita and that can be really useful for game development. However, I don't want to show you all of the features in a row because unless you are very experienced with digital art, this won't be very useful to you. You will learn tons of things, but you won't necessarily know how to combine the tools together or how to apply what we learned. That is why in the second chapter, we are going to talk about workflow, we are going to talk about game art, and we are going to talk about how we can combine the tools we have seen to create art for games in Krita.